Girl Scouts of Greater South Texas. I hope you're ready for some more virtual fun. Let's get started with the Girl Scout Promise and the Girl Scout Law. We're going to raise our right hand, pinky down, and thumb over our pinky. If you don't know the promise, you can repeat after me, but if you do know it, definitely say it with me. On my honor, I will try to serve God and my country, to help people at all times, and to live by the Girl Scout Law. Now the Girl Scout Law. Again, if you don't know it, repeat after me, but if you do know it, definitely say it with me. I will do my best to be honest and fair, friendly and helpful, considerate and caring, courageous and strong, and responsible for what I say and do, and to respect myself and others, respect authority, use resources wisely, make the world a better place, and be a sister to every Girl Scout. Now let's get started. At Girl Scouts, we are helping to build girls of courage, confidence, and character who make the world a better place. We know that each one of you Girl Scouts is strong and powerful and has the skills and abilities to make an impact on your community and the world. Now more than ever is the time to find your voice and use it to be advocates for ideas and issues that are important to you. Girl Scouts is made up of individuals who hold beliefs as diverse as the nation itself. Girl Scouts encourages each and every one of you to stay informed so that you can form your own ideas, opinions, beliefs, and political views. This week, we will be focusing on the Girl Scout Legacy Citizen Badges because finding your voice is important at any age or level. A symbol is an object that means something special. For example, we Girl Scouts wear special symbols on our uniform and our insignia tabs that represent our level of Girl Scouts, or the number of years that you've been in Girl Scouts, or even special awards or skills that you've earned along the way. So symbols are a big part of Girl Scouts. There are symbols within our organization, as well as the community that we live in. Each state has their own symbols. The states have mottos, flags, trees, birds, those are all symbols that represent that community or that state or that city. So symbols are important to learn and know. Did you know that our state motto for Texas is friendship? The name Texas originates from a Native American word, Tayshus, which means friends or allies. Do you think our motto fits our state? I challenge you to look up the state symbols like our state bird or state tree or state flower. You may already know them, but it's always good to refresh on what our Texas symbols are. Your activity for today is to choose a flower, bird, and tree and motto for yourself. Pick a symbol for yourself and think about why you would choose those symbols for yourself. For example, I think I would choose a palm tree as my tree symbol because palm trees are tall and I'm very tall and they get knocked around in the wind a lot, but they still stay strong, and I love that about palm trees, and they remind me of where I'm from as well. So I would definitely choose the palm tree for my tree symbol. What symbols would you choose to represent you? What motto really speaks to you and makes you feel like that's a symbol that represents you? Think about these things and choose those symbols to represent you as your activity. I hope you have fun looking up more community symbols and choosing symbols for yourself. I can't wait for more virtual fun with you next time. We'll see you soon, sisters.